Hey everyone, welcome to Coding Simplified, and now we'll see that how to use super keyword in Java, right? So super keyword is basically related to the inheritance. So in inheritance, what we do, we say basically we are inheriting the properties of super class, right? And in last tutorial we saw that how to use method overriding and how we go for the polymorphism, runtime polymorphism, right? So in method overriding, what we say, let's say if you have a method name with same return type, same argument list, then basically method override, right? So like here as well, you can see that here I have my base class where I have print method, and then in my subclass also I have this print method, right? So this print method is overriding the subclass, the overriding the superclass method, right? And now we have seen from the polymorphism that which method would run depends on your object, right? So like here, if I am creating the object of subclass, then subclass method will call, right? But sometime it happen that I want to call the superclass method as well, right? Or I want to access the superclass variable as well. So in that case, basically we need the super keyword, right? So let's take example first from the method. So what happens, like if you see here that I have this print method, right? So in print, what will happen, that I know that this is the object of subclass. So now this subclass method will call and it would print in subclass, right? But if I want to access this superclass method as well, because I know that there are something, because these are simple printing, but there can be some statement in the superclass which I want to execute, right? So how can I execute that? So for that, what we do, basically here I write super dot print, right? And now what will happen, that when I will call this object, method overriding object, and when I will call this print, so it will call the print method of this one subclass, and then here I have written super dot print, and then here it will call the method of main class, the subclass, or sorry, base class, right? And then it will print in base class print, and then it would print in subclass, right? So if you run the program, so let me comment out this one, and if you run the program, you can see that first it has printed in base class print, and then it printed in subclass. So that is how we use a super in method whenever you want to access the superclass method, right? So this is how we say super dot and then method name. Now let's see that how we can use it in with variable, right? So here I have a method setX, right? So here what I'm doing, now whenever this setX will call, and here you know that I have this x equal to 2 and here also x equal to 1, right? So now if I say x equals to b, it will basically initialize the x equal to 2, right? But now let's say if I want to initialize a superclass x as well, right? So how can I initialize? So I can initialize using super variable. So what I will do, I'll say that super dot x equals to a, right? So now what will happen, that as soon as you will call this set x, then it will call this function, right? Because you are executing of this one, so that is why it will call this one. So now it will say that super dot x, it means whatever the variable of the super class, means this one, then initialize the value of by a, right? So it will initialize super dot x equal to a, and then it will initialize x equal to b, right, which is of the subclass. So that is how we use super keyword for the variables, right? And now see that how we can use super with the constructor. So what happens, let's say here I have a constructor of this subclass, right? And here I have a sub constructor of the base class. So now what happens, let's say if I am printing here in base class constructor, and if I print here the superclass constructor, sorry, subclass constructor, right? Now what will happen, that whenever you will call the object of this one, it would call the constructor of this one, of the subclass, right? So now what happens, that implicitly whenever you, if you are overriding any subclass, if you are overriding any class, then implicitly before executing the statement in the superclass on the subclass, it will first call the constructor of the superclass. So now what would happen? That before executing this one, it would first execute, it will call the superclass constructor, means it will call this one base class, and then it will execute first base class constructor, and then it will execute subclass constructor, right? So run the program, and then you will see that as soon as I created an object, it basically called the method overriding, and then it called the base constructor. So first this statement executed base class constructor that you have seen from here, and then it will call the subclass constructor. Right. So what is happening, that implicitly it is basically calling the superclass constructor, right? So basically if you see that it is doing this thing, right? Implicitly it is calling the superclass constructor, and that is how we use a super keyword in constructor, right? And because this is a default constructor, but let's say if we have constructor with the values, so let's say int a, right? So now what would happen, and let's say if I want to execute the here, so what I can do, I can basically have a another constructor here which is int a, right? So now what I'm doing, I'm saying that whenever you call the method overriding constructor with the parameterized constructor, then I want to call the super class with the super a. Now there is a point that if you are using super in the constructor, then it should be the first statement, right? So like, let's say if you try to put the super here, then it won't work, it would give you compile time error, right? It will say that constructor call must be the first statement in the constructor, right? But if you are trying to do it on the method, there is not issue. So in fact, you can put it here, this is fine, right? And this is valid for here as well, right? This is also fine, right? Because here what you are doing, you are just calling the superclass method, you are calling the superclass variable, but here the super constructor implicitly call always a superclass, so this is always mandatory. So that's it guys about this video. We have seen that how we can use super in different scenarios. We can use super with the method whenever you want to call the method of the superclass. We can call the super with the variable whenever we want to access the superclass variable, and whenever I want to access the super constructor, then I can use the super, right? And implicitly super constructor called in the default constructor, right? So that's it about it, and if you have any doubt regarding it, please write in the comment section and I will try to explain that. And guys, if you have liked the video, then please like it and subscribe the channel for more such videos. Thank you.